Thank you so much for the testimony. I'm so blessed. I just want to say thank you to the church, the pastor, Pastor Babi, even the entire leadership of the church for giving us this opportunity to stand before you all. It's my pleasure. And I bless the Lord God Almighty who has given me this opportunity even coming here. So I just want to say thank you even to the Sanchez's family. They are so nice to us. You can feel at home hanging around with them, even the time we are spending with them, even communicating on phone, stuff like that. It's very rare. It's uncommon finding people like them. And I know a lot of you in here, you are like that couple there. Because me being around with you, even hanging around with you guys, it's amazing. And I'm enjoying being around you guys. So I appreciate so very much. And before we go into the Word of God, I just want to share with you something quickly, what we are doing back there in Zambia, or what the Lord is doing through us in Zambia. There, I know my wife, she has shared already how we went down there at the mission and how the Lord spoke to us that this is where we are supposed to be when it comes to the ministry, because we were on our way going to Kitwe and plant the church there, but the Lord had to redirect our direction, and we thank God for that. Yeah, so quickly, even myself, I just want to say thank you to the Callaway's family. They are faithful. When I say they are these guys, and on behalf of GCMS back there in Zambia, I just want to say thank you for sending this couple to Zambia. God has used them so much, and maybe some of the things themselves, they don't know what God has done through their lives. So we appreciate so very much, and we know that we'll continue ministering together, even if we are going to be this side. So we thank God for that. So quickly, I just want to share with you, as I said earlier on, I'm at the mission there, I and my wife, we are committed staying there at the mission, even working with the Pastor Pule, working with him, operating under his leadership. Right now, by the grace of God, I am operating there at the mission as Dean of Students. We have the Bible Institute, NSBI. Also with the pastors, I'm helping. And also I'm one of the restoration pastors. I think Brian, he has shared already when God laid upon his heart concerning that ministry, so that we can start helping the struggling churches. Yeah, and we have seen the hand of God when it comes to restoration. Even the church I'm helping right now, we are no longer the same. We have seen the hand of God, and God is doing amazing things. So we thank God for that. Also, I think 3 months and some weeks ago, I don't know if it's 4 months, we started a ministry using the soccer balls, mobilizing the youths, bringing them together at the mission station there. We have the team, and God is working the young men and women, because we have 2 groups, the young men and the women. So they have been coming, and we have been ministering God's word to them, and God had to provide some equipment. But it is my prayer to see that God extend this ministry even into other different places. Yeah, I know I was a professional soccer player. I know in Zambia when you call yourself a professional, because back there in Zambia they know that somebody, if you call yourself a professional, it means you have played outside Zambia. Yeah, but what I know is a professional soccer player is someone who has played when it comes to sign the contract, stuff like that, and they are paying you. But back there in Zambia, they think you have to play outside. Myself, I never had that opportunity to play outside. I wanted, that was my desire, but God had to redirect so that I can follow him and do according to what he wants me to do. So I thank God for that. So when we go back there in Zambia, I and my wife, we are planning to focus on the youth ministry. Yes, Pastor Fule will be in charge, but I and my wife, we are planning to focus on the ministry so that we can continue investing in the youths. Because if we invest in the youths, it means we are going to have stronger churches in future. So it is my prayer that we invest whatever God has done in our lives, even the knowledge God has given, we invest in them. Not investing in knowledge only, but also our lives and being examples and examples to them so that they can follow Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. So that's what God is doing. Maybe in future, if God allows, God has laid this upon my heart. I don't know when God is going to say, okay, now you have to start doing this. God has laid upon my heart to start planting churches in the cities. Like having something like pastors' course in the cities. We have many churches in the bush area. We have many churches. So even in towns, because if you go in town, yes, we have many churches, but it's not everyone who is preaching the truth in town. LSCs are there, and most of the people, they think that they know Jesus Christ, they are saved, but in the actual sense, they are not. So we have to reach everywhere, in bush area, even in the cities. So if God allows, we are planning to extend also in the cities in the future. So be in prayer for that. And it's my prayer that God is going to bring faithful men. Yeah, faithful men, uncommon men. Because this is huge. I and my wife, we cannot do it alone. So we need your prayers. Please continue praying for us.